Savior, Lord. Now we're going to open up this portion of our service for those who like to sing and testify to the glory and honor of God. Come on, Deacon Cleotis.
Bless every saint, Lord. Bless all your people assembled in Jesus' holy and precious name. Amen.
Amen. With our pastoral address. So we'll start with some of those folks. Start with Sister Donna. She already smiling. And, go ahead and talk to the Lord.
Yeah, I'm excited to see my family. I love everybody. I just want to say, order my steps, Lord. Everything I do, Lord, I want you to do it with me, Lord. I want you to hold my hand, Lord. And I hope I've learned everything you wanted me to learn through this epidemic, Lord. I just trust you, Lord. Whatever you tell me to do, I do it, Lord. I believe in your word, Lord. Fix it, Lord. Whatever we need fixing, Lord, fix it. I give you praise, Lord, like never before, in the name of Jesus. Give God some praise, y'all.
Hallelujah.
I think this is Donna ready to blast off.
Oh, yeah.
Somebody better go get out of the house.
I can't wait for church to get back.
You can't wait for church to get back?
I can't wait. I'm telling you.
Donna just fool.
I got, yes, I am. I got to pray for the Lord. I tell you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Don't get us started. She's going to cry in about 5 seconds. 5 seconds, she's gone.
Yes, I will.
Let's go to Sister Harden and Sister Krishan Coleman.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank the Lord. I wanted to get my mom on. We have been praying for her with her blood pressure, and the Lord has been blessing with that. So we just want to give God praise for that. And we want to thank the Lord for just protecting and keeping us and just watching over us. And know that I love you all. I miss you all. And I just thank God that, you know, we had an opportunity to have this all. God knows everything, and he placed everything in order. He knew what was going to happen, and I just thank God that we as a PDT family was ready and equipped so that we could still be able to see each other, still have church, still be able to give my tithes and my offerings, because I love to be a blessing to the ministry. So I just thank God for just making a way. Hallelujah. To make sure that we had everything in place in order so we can all still go on with the Lord. Ain't no stopping when it comes to the Lord. So I've been praising him, and I've been thanking the Lord for all the testimony services and with the Zoom and with the word that's been coming forth. And I just thank God that we ain't missed a beat. PDT ain't missed a beat. We owe it all to God.
Amen.
I'm going to say something. This is the, I call her Aunt Pat. She's my aunt in real life. You want to say something, Aunt Pat?
I thank you, Lord, for being with y'all. Every morning when your prayers come along, Lord, it's been very good to me because I have been through all these things, but the Lord is keeping me, and he's blessing me, and he loves me, and oh, Lord, I'm telling you, it's been kind of hard, but Jesus is fixing everything all right, and God will take care of me and carry me on what need to be done and to carry out. And I thank y'all for praying for me, and I love you all. Give God praise. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. She'll be on there before I do.
Amen. She's a prayer warrior.
It's been a blessing. It's been a blessing to me. That's why I'm still standing still.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. If you've ever been through any health challenges before, you don't really care about anything else that goes on and happens in the world once God restores your health.
Amen.
You just feel grateful to be alive, grateful to have strength, grateful to have family by your side. So I love testimonies like that. Let's go to Deacon Blackman.
Yeah, praise the Lord, saints.
Praise the Lord, Deacon.
Yeah, good to see everybody. Yeah, love y'all and miss y'all very much. Yeah, I'm going to have to show y'all a video of my son. Every time the broadcast comes on, he starts running and shouting. So, I'm going to have a video of that.
Yeah. Amen. Let's see your man, little D, on here and let him speak.
Yeah, he misses you, Pastor.
Let him testify.
Yeah, every time we see you, you start. All right, come here, son. Here he comes.
Yeah.
Yeah,
we gotta
have some
theme music.
Hey, Junior.
Hey, little D, how you doing? Praise the Lord, man. Praise the Lord. Come on, clap your hands.
Yeah, you see, Pastor?
Come on, clap your hands.
Yeah.
You got some praise.
There he is. The
Lord.
It's all right. Don't get shy now.
Hey, Lord, out of
green.
Hey,
yes.
Get you back on these drums.
Oh, yeah.
He's not used to this kind of communication yet.
No.
Yeah. Pastor, First Lady here. Let's get you to say something really quickly, and then we'll keep it going with the saints.
Praise the Lord. Ladies always first.
When I look back over my life and I think things over, I can truly say, all right, I've been blessed. I got a testimony. When we look back on our life and we think things over, we got to give God praise. He's been good to all of us. Amen. And I'm excited about Testimony Tuesday, just to be able to have a chance to just give him praise and glory, to see all your smiling faces, all the saints that I miss. I wish I could hug you, but I'm going to give you a virtual hug. All right? Virtual hug. Love you guys, and I just really want to thank God for being so good to us through this epidemic that we're all going through, and thank God for help and strength, all this family so far in the PDT church family. It's doing well. You know, we're talking to different people every week to check in, and God has just blessed the saints, and we're just so grateful, and it's because we have favor. Hallelujah. And when you have favor, it's something that you need to be thankful for. The pastor often preached sometimes. He said, if somebody do something for you, at least you can do is praise them and thank them. Mm-hmm. And so this is a great opportunity for us just to thank the Lord for all that he's done. And I'm excited. Amen. Can't wait to see what he's going to do next. Thank you. God bless you.
Well, with that being said, I got to praise and thank the Lord today, because as some of you know, I told you yesterday that we were going down to pick up our building permit today, and I had to get the workers' comp insurance before I could pick up the permit.
Yes.
And they were going to charge $1,500, and it had to be paid in cash, and couldn't get no premium finance or any of that. Had to be paid in one sum. And so he sent me the application, and I start looking over the application. And we start talking about different things on the application, and he found out that he had made an error on the application. And so he went back and resubmitted, and the premium went from $1,500 to $504.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Wow.
For the financial blessing.
Amen.
And I'm just praise.
$1,000 blessing. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
God is good.
If God gave somebody out $1,000, we couldn't hold you down. We couldn't get no order on the Zoom call. But I just thank God and praise God for the blessing. Not only that, I praise him for just being in health and strength and being in the right mind and being able to continue to minister from the platforms that we have. Even though I may not have had experience in these platforms, I believe that we're still able to be effective in ministering to the
Amen.
People of God anyway. And so I just praise God for that.
Amen.
And just continue to stay encouraged, continue to be faithful, and listen, the devil can't hold us down because we have the victory. And so therefore, it's just a matter of time until he gets over this pandemic and we get back to the praise image.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Let's go to the Lewises that are in Indian Trail by way of the Golden Gate Bridge in San Francisco.
Amen. Yeah, we're down here in India. Man. Still trying to find wax. They say there are Indians down here, but I haven't seen any yet. But I just thank and praise God that we don't have to find Indians in order to see him. But And thank God for this opportunity, you know, just to be able to come cybernetically together to praise God and to fellowship with everybody. You know, there's no substitute for a fellowship, and this is definitely a reasonable substitute within this means. So I thank and praise God just to be able to do this. I know everybody can't do it, but I just thank and praise God for the times we live in. And you know, it does a lot. It does a lot for me to be able to just hear everybody's voices and to see that everyone's doing well. And if it's not so well, then, you know, we know what the prayer requests are, and we can openly pray together. So I just thank and praise God that me and my wife are doing fine here, and my puppy dog, and my mom.
Let me see the dog.
The dog is over here.
Let me see the dog.
Yeah.
Come on, Toby. Toby, give your praise.
Tell Toby to give his praise report. All right, Toby, give your praise report.
He's trying to see what's going on. He's figuring it out, but I think praise God.
Toby, praise God for some dry dog food. Canned dog food.
He's well cared for.
We thank and praise
so
God.
So cute.
But yeah, we thank and praise God for, you know, for the ministry, and we just want to be a support, and it's not a hard thing just to jump online and to get involved this way. So I thank and praise God for this availability.
In Amen. Jesus' name. Amen. Well, praise the Lord, saints.
Praise the Lord. Praise
the Lord.
I just thank and praise the Lord for so many things. But first and foremost, tonight, I thank God for strength, because I am one of those people that still has to go to work. And if I don't go into the office, I have to work here. And when I get off this call, I'm going into the office here at home to do some more work. But I thank and praise the Lord for strength. What I really want to thank and praise the Lord, because he shows us so many things through this experience, is about his timing. And when I think about that, you know, the Lord opened up a door for the ministry back in March. And we had 1 week where we had to really blitz this opportunity to maximize what God had for the ministry. But if we think about it, within 5 days of us finishing that project, we went to shelter in place and things started changing. And it just shows God opens up windows. He opens up windows of opportunity for people, whether individually or collectively as a church or as a body of Christ. He opens up opportunities, and we have to be in position to take advantage of those opportunities and understand and see those opportunities as God. And so for that, I thank and praise the Lord for that tonight, because, you know, the world is having one experience and we're having a different experience, and that's God. And we have to understand and know that we do belong to him. And it's just so many things that he has shown me, I know, through this experience for myself. And you're right, Elder, several messages. I don't know when he's going to pull them out, but he's put them in. And I just thank and praise the Lord for his provision. And just on the comical side, as I was riding home tonight, so we need to have a marriage enrichment Zoom call, because as I was driving home, I always call my husband and say, honey, I'm on my way home. To which my husband said, well, you know, you got a desk and a chair and a refrigerator with food and electricity in the garage. And so I said, well, you're going to let me in the house, right? So he said he wouldn't let me in the house. But I just thank and praise the Lord. But we might have to do a marriage enrichment Zoom call to keep all of us going in the right direction.
Absolutely.
Of course, I was teasing.
Yeah, I'm in the house. But I thank and praise the Lord that we can smile and we can have humor. It is so good to see all of your faces. I can't wait till we come together. But I think we've also learned that the church is so much bigger than the walls. In Jesus' name.
Let's go, Sister Christina here. Let's go, Christina, and have her bless the saints.
Hey, I was, Marquita had invited me. I'm her neighbor. I was just telling her how thankful we are. Me and my husband to still have our jobs. He works for CarMax, and they actually just furloughed over half of their employees, and we were fortunate enough that he still has his job right now. So I just wanted thank the Lord for that, definitely. Mm-hmm. And we're very thankful that we're still healthy. We have two twins and a three-year-old. Our twins are 8 months old, but they were 2 months premature. So, I mean, I work in healthcare, and I got to make sure that they stay healthy and I stay mm-hmm. healthy. And I just pray every day that the Lord keeps us healthy and keeps us away from this virus. So I definitely want to praise the Lord for that.
Amen.
I have actually cooked for her, so thank you. But I just want to thank God for just being healthy and in my right mind today. I thank God for allowing my mom, a couple of my neighbors, Miss Waters and Christina, to be on the call with us today. So I'm very thankful that they're able to just share in our testimony today. Because God has been so good, you know, we're alive and well. And, you know, just being grateful for all the little things. I'm thankful for just being able to have a job that, you know, I'm still busy every day. The company that I work for, you know, I'm always busy. You know, there's never no work to be done. I mean, they're always giving me more things to do. So I'm very grateful for that. I'm thankful that I'm able to work from home, that my kids are doing well. And, you know, my grandmother, she turned 85 last week. So I'm very grateful for so many different things. I'm thankful. Just like Christina was sharing earlier, her kids were premature, and I'm thankful that I was just able to be a blessing to her every now and then, you know, just to say, hey, if you ever need anything, just let me know. Mm-hmm. And those things just go a long way, because Miss Waters, her family have, you know, put me into their family and just made me feel like I'm a part of theirs, even from being away from home. So I'm grateful for them as well. And just my mom for being mom all the time. So I'm grateful for her. I'm thankful that she's doing much better today. She's had her off days sometimes, but today I'm just thankful that she's able to be on the call.
Amen.
Wonderful. Amen. I praise God for each of you. I praise God for this opportunity to express all the some of what Jesus is doing. I thank him because there are so many millions of people who are out of work, yet the saints of God are praying, the saints of God are sending their timber up to the Lord. And my daughter Vanessa was out of work when the pandemic started, and she had absolutely no income. She used up all the funds that she had trying to maintain the household. And during that pandemic, the Lord blessed her with, we had been six years for her to get a permanent position. She had worked under contracted positions. And during the pandemic, the Lord gave her a position with a job making even a little more pay than she had was making before the pandemic. And they didn't stop there. They could have probably let her go because the pandemic started. But instead of that, they gave her a computer and allowed her to work from home. She's on her second paycheck now, hallelujah. And amen. I thank God for Jesus. I amen. Gave that request to the saints on the prayer line. And the Lord heard the prayer of the righteous. It availed much. She is now working. I also pray for, thank God for my son. Prayer changes things. I have a son who was out of work for years, many years. I put his request in before the saints in Heavenly Vision in Syracuse, New York. They prayed for him. He received a permanent job. He's working from home. God, Jesus is able to bless our seed, not to curse them. And I thank God that he's blessing my seed, that he's healing folk, that he's bringing them out of the hospital, and they are faring well. I thank God for Michael Wells, hallelujah, who is out of the hospital and faring well in Jesus' name. I thank God for Sister Alisa Burke, who is home. I thank God for Jada, her child, hallelujah, who had pneumonia, but the Lord delivered her. You know, God is doing great things for his people in the midst of this pandemic, hallelujah. Yes, we are losing souls, hallelujah. We are losing some souls, but they're calling election, and election has come. God has said, you have done a good work. Well done, that good and faithful servant. Servant, hallelujah. So I thank God for those who are passed on, but I thank God for those that are holding on, that are praying for the saints, that are praying for the bishops, that are praying for the pew members, that are praying for the workers. Pray for me in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Man, I felt that.
Yes.
I felt that, Evangelist Ryan. Let's go to one of my favorite couples. I saw that they were on, the Mendozas. Let's go to the Mendozas really quick.
Hi. Hello.
Hey. Hey. How are you, Brother Mendoza?
Hello. Hello. We're here today, and we're very happy to be here. Today's our 41st wedding anniversary.
Awesome.
Amen.
Amen. I'm glad to be a part of here, and my wife, Claudia, to put you on to my wife, Claudia.
Hi.
Hello.
Nice to see Mendoza. Everyone. Thank you. Nice to see everyone today. Today we're celebrating our 41st wedding anniversary.
Hallelujah.
Amen. 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 Anniversary.
Yeah, they bought us gifts, cake, so, you know.
Oh, beautiful.
And besides, you know, yesterday, they talked about reference and two family members who got attacked with the COVID virus. Well, we lost one of the family members yesterday to the virus.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. What we lost one today, and one came out of the hospital today.
Amen.
Well, you definitely have our condolences.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, so we're doing good. Nice to see everyone. We'll be happy to be back in church again when that day permits and time comes.
Yeah, I can't wait till we get back to church and get to bless the Lord together. We applaud and salute you. I wish we could sing an anniversary song to you, but I don't have my keyboard hooked up. I would play.
One of my granddaughters said, Grandma, it's your birthday. I said, anniversary. She said, let's sing happy anniversary. And she sang a song. She made it up.
Oh, awesome. You should have got on and sang it to you for us.
She has a cousin visiting her now, so she's a little busy downstairs.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Well, we thank you all for coming on. Happy anniversary. We're honored that you could take out the time during your anniversary to spend a little time with us. Even though you're shut in, you could have just said, hey, we'll skip this Tuesday.
No.
We appreciate it.
Thank you.
I see that we have Sister Aaliyah McCoy.
All right.
In the building. We're going to go to her. We've been praying for you hard, sister. We've been praying for your family. Mm-hmm. We're going to go to her really quickly.
Yeah. Praise God. Grace and peace be multiplied under the sound of my voice in the name of Jesus. I just want to tell y'all, I love y'all, and y'all are forever in my heart.
Amen. It's so good to see you.
Good to see you, my sister.
Yes, this is a difficult time, but you know, I feel that I got my niece here with me. She helped me get it on over there.
Hey, Mom.
Hey. They'll be hanging in there.
Yes.
That's what I'm talking about.
Man, God bless.
I love your mom's smile. She got an infectious smile. She's one of those type of people that you can't look at her and not smile because she smiles. Thankful for her and your niece and the entire family. For those of you who don't know, Sister Leah is my fish. I answer the church's phone. And she called one Sunday morning.
She's the one that ministered to me and brought me to the church 19 years ago.
Testify. Tell them about it.
Right. 13 years ago, I called the church because I just had came to Charlotte from New York, and I had called the church, and his wife, Joy, picked up the phone. Oh, my God. She is just the essence of holiness. She is just wonderful. And she said to me, she couldn't answer all my questions. She said, but let me put my husband on the phone. He said, I don't know about them questions, but I know if you gave me your address, I can come and pick you up. Yes, man. Yes. And I'm ever so grateful. I'm ever so grateful. Minister Green, everything that you have taught me in that ground and rooted class, I am using it. Look, I found my notes, Minister Green, from 2006. I got my ground and rooted notes that I had at my mother's house. I'm reading them and I'm trying to live it.
She's trying to get on.
That's awesome. That's a plug. When we get back to church, we're gonna start that back. It's called Take Root and Bear Fruit.
Amen. And
it's funny that you would say that, Sister Leah. I literally looked through my manual and my notes.
I kept my one. God is so good. I left one of my. I came up here to visit my mom, and I left a notepad at her house in my old room. So when I came back here after my son died, I was going through some stuff, and I found my ground and rooted notes. And right when I had to go identify my son's body, some of the stuff came up in there. I pulled my phone out to call you, but I couldn't read you. But all of that stuff that I wrote down in that book, God just started ministering. That thing that they be saying, when you train a child in the way that it should go, when they get old, it won't depart from them. Because I left you and came back up here. And everything that what you taught me, I just asked the Holy Ghost, stir it up, and it just starts coming out.
Amen.
Wow, I'm telling you, the confirmation, so I literally.
Y'all have really taught me how to get in touch with God. Amen. I was thinking church was something completely different. I know him like I never knew him before.
Praise God.
Say, I know him.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Yes.
I've had some experiences.
And I'm ever so grateful. Sister Wooda, I just love you. Sister Wooda, that Sister Lynch. Oh, God, I miss all of y'all. But that's all right, because at an appointed time, we shall get back together.
Amen.
Absolutely. Amen. I'm telling you, that's a confirmation. I literally yesterday looked through the teacher's manual of both of those courses. And pastor is my witness, because I was in his office doing some work for the church and for our broadcast. And I just looked over because the books are in his office, sitting right on the counter. And I literally just looked through that and said, man, when we get back to church, we got to implement to take root and bear fruit. So it's amazing that you would come with that confirmation saying that you just found your notes and reflecting on that class. It's nothing but God. So I know it's a God thing. It's something that we're going to have to do emphatically.
Everybody's trying to figure out why I'm not breaking down and crying, because my son died and my other son just died. But they don't know I done found my ground and rooted notes.
Wow.
And then that note, you remember you taught me, Minister Green, about the dunamis power?
Yes, ma'am.
You remember you taught me that, right?
Yes, ma'am.
And then you went to Acts 1 and 8, and you told me I had that power. And I had to get that power activated. How did I get that power activated? You taught me to go to the manual, which is the Bible. You said, stay with your manual. Whatever you do, you got a manual.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
You remember you taught me that?
I'm remembering now.
Yes, you have taught me that, and I'm ever so grateful, because that's what sustained me throughout all of this tragedy and stuff. What we say is the tragedy, it's really the will of God.
Mm.
He had to shake something up.
Yes.
Yes.
I'm humbled, Sister Leah. I'm like Paul. I'm just delivering what was delivered unto me. I can't take no credit. I can't be vaulted up in, you know, I taught Sister Leah. No, I'm just passing down what was passed down to me. So now it's your responsibility to pass it down to somebody else. Take those notes and share them with somebody else. Change somebody's life, put an imprint on their life so that 5 years from now they'll be talking about, Sister Leah talked to me in the grocery store and changed my life.
Yes.
That's what it's all about. It's just one person sharing the gospel. We're just witnesses. And all a witness does is testifies to what they've seen, heard, or experienced. So that's what we're here doing tonight.
Only by his grace. Absolutely. You know what else I found out, Minister Green? I found out. Now I know what they be talking about when they say the joy of the Lord is my strength. Because a lot of things around you might not be to your liking.
Amen.
I not understand a lot of things, but life happens. And I learned that life does what it do. Life can give to you and life can take away from you.
Absolutely.
It's how you embrace it. And it's just a exhilarating feeling when you start to see the manifestation of God come, because it's nothing like what it appears to be. It's nothing like that, but I had to learn that. But I'm grateful, and I thank and praise God for y'all. I love my pastor and my first lady. I gave them a difficult time, but glory to God, it helped make me to who I am today.
Absolutely. Do we have anybody
else?
I want
to say a testimony if she could.
Absolutely. Let's go to Mom.
I want to testify to the fact that from the bottom of my heart, I appreciate y'all taking my daughter in, because Leah came here and saved my life. If it wasn't for Leah, I thought I would be talking to her right now. Leah got here.
Hi.
She looked at me. She said, "No, mommy, you real sick. You gotta go." She took me there. That's when they found out that my gallstones had exploded in my stomach and was blocking up other stuff. They had to operate. They had to do an emergency operation. And then the next day, they operated and took it out. So I had two operations, not even back to back, not even 12 hours apart.
Wow. Yeah.
So it wasn't.
Thank you.
My daughter was not. If she would have been anyplace else, I know I wouldn't. I wouldn't be talking to you right now. I just want to thank God for y'all being who y'all are.
Thank you.
We want to thank God that you're here.
Thank you, Jesus.
I always did love your church. I always did want to be there, but I lived up here, and I couldn't get the. Where I can migrate to down there, because that's what I need to do. So I'm gonna let God work it out.
We gonna get you.
Amen. Amen.
Everything that,
amen, Mom.
Everything that goes up must come down.
Amen.
So,
I'm
waiting for you to come on down here.
Yeah.
Make sure.
And you know,
well.
In my heart, this is what I wanted to do.
Yes, ma'am. I believe that you'll breathe better down here. The air is just better down here.
Amen.
You don't have so much stress. Right. We got Sister Valerie all the way from upstate New York. She can't stay from down here. It's just something about the Carolinas.
Yeah, there's something about down there.
Yes, ma'am.
That's right.
Yes, ma'am. I believe we have Sister Deborah Edwards. I'm not sure if she's able to talk, and then we'll go to Sister Lynch.
Okay, God bless y'all.
Yes, ma'am. God bless you as well. Let's see, Sister Deborah Edwards.
I am able to talk. I just want to thank the Lord for waking me up this morning in my right mind, health, and strength. Bless me mentally, physically, financially. Strengthen me where I'm weak. And anytime I travel from my mom's house to the grocery store to get us something to eat, and giving me traveling mercy. I thank the Lord for Marquita, who be fussing at me when I go to the doctor. Because she thinks she's my mama. Like I tell my mama, I'm her mama. But I've been having some issues not being stable. With being dizzy and stuff. So I've been trying to sit down and stay still. And thank the Lord that I fell, and it wasn't as bad as it was. I fractured my knee, but I'm doing quite well.
Thank you.
Amen. And we glad.
Yes, and thank the Lord. My mom's seeing her 85th birthday.
Thank you, Lord.
She's been home. She had me going to church because she's on the walker, and I've been having a time with it. That nobody would know that I've been having a time with, but I know that she's well. As she tell me, she's ready. Either way it goes, she's ready. She's standing on ready, waiting on ready. She's ready. Either way it goes. So
amen.
Thank the Lord that she's in her right mind and everything. She hurt all the time, but she's doing quite well. But amen. Thank you. I'm thankful to be on the call tonight because I did not know. I don't do the computer stuff well. So thank the Lord that my kitty got me on.
Amen. For those of you that don't know, this is Sister Marquita's mom. She's such a jewel. We thank God that she's in good health and God is helping her with her health. And we also will be in prayer for you. Anybody that's ever been a caretaker knows it's full-time job. It's not easy. Sometimes it's sleepless nights for yourself because you're constantly looking out for that person. So I pray for your strength. I know the feeling, like Sister Marquita, sometimes you feel like you are the parent when you're the child, because you got to make sure that your parents are taken care of. I've been the caretaker for my dad several times, and I've had to have some come to Jesus moments with him. Say, all right, Dad, it's time for you to take your medicine. It's time for you to do this. It's time for you to sit down. So listen to Sister Marquita. She only wishes the best for you. I know how it is. So we pray for your strength. We pray that God continues to restore you and give you good health. All right, let's go to Sister Lynch.
Praise the Lord, saints.
I know she has a fiery testimony.
Praise the Lord, everyone. God bless you. I just want to say today, it is well with my soul. God is good all the time. All the time. God is good. I just praise God today for all his many blessings and how he's continued to bless and watch over and keep my family. Thank God we have no sad stories to tell. I just thank God that I'm encouraged today. I know that through it all, and when this is all over, I believe and I know that greater is coming. Greater is coming. And God wants us to be grateful for all the things that we have, to be grateful for the people in our lives. So many times we take those people for granted. And just like I listened to everyone saying how we miss one another and how the times I think, as with your natural family, there's times we've gotten on each other's nerves and can't see each other. That's real. At this point, we just thank God to know that everyone is safe, everyone is well, and that God is yet in control. Be encouraged, saints. Choose faith over fear. Don't fear. You have to just be still and know that God is God and trust God to do what he's going to do. And in the end, we shall come out with the victory. Be encouraged. God bless you. We love you.
God bless you.
God bless you.
Amen.
Amen.
Love you too.
One of my favorite scriptures is Psalm 27. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? Evil, even the wicked and my enemies and my foes came upon me to eat up my flesh. They stumbled and fell, though a host shall encamp against me, though war shall rise against me, in one thing will I be confident. One thing have I desired of the Lord, and that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of his life, behold the beauty of the Lord, and inquire in his temple. This is the part I like. But in the time of trouble, of his tabernacle shall have me be upon a rock, and how shall my eyes be lifted up above my enemies. I tell them all the things, be encouraged, know that God is with us. Know that we don't have to be afraid of anything. Where there's an abundance of faith, there is little fear. Where there's an abundance of fear, there's little faith. So I pray that God maximizes your faith. As Christ told Peter, I have prayed for you that your faith fail you not. No matter what you're going through, no matter what you're dealing with, no matter what the hardship is, know that God has your back, and we're going to make it through this together. So, Pastor, we have about 3 minutes. If you can tell us the 3 minutes.
Well, Elder Green.
Dismiss us before we close.
Can you hear me now, Elder Green?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Since I got y'all talking about the scriptures, I'm going to take a nap now. That's what I've been trying to do for the whole time. And since it seemed like y'all got it. I can sleep well tonight. But I thank God for this opportunity, this occasion. It is just so good sometimes to just open the door and let people talk and get out some of the things that they're feeling on the inside. And I'm just excited to know that the Lord has become the author and finisher of our lives, and that the testimonies are going forth. Sister Leah, we are so elated that you would be with us on tonight.
Amen.
We are certainly praying for you. Stay encouraged. And I just have one observation and one question. I can't figure out how your hair is so pressed. And I hadn't seen the barber in 6-8 weeks. But yours,
the weeds, God said that's the weeds.
I don't know what that's all about. Nevertheless,
that a weed.
And we just thank God. We're not going to prolong the hour. You can tell us about your hairdo next time. But we're going to close out.
We love you guys, and your mom and family.
Yes.
Go find me.
So good to see you guys.
Yes. And we'll have our time. We'll have our time. But I want to close out with a word of prayer before we go, because it's been about an hour now. All right? So I want all hearts and minds to come together in a unified manner and focus on the blood of Jesus and his atoning blood and what he did for us and how he bled and died for us and how this hour. So God, we thank you and we praise you right now for this time that we have had to spend together to talk with each other, God, and to, Lord, at least see that each other are doing well. And God, we pray that you will continue to keep our hearts and our minds regulated and keep them stayed upon you. And God, we pray that you will continue to heal your people, God, in spirit, God, and physically. We know you're able to do it, and we bind the adversary. We bind the enemy for what he's trying to do. We know he doesn't like this kind of fellowship. He doesn't like any kind of fellowship, but greater is he that's in us than he that's in the world. And God, we thank you for this time of fellowship, this virtual fellowship. But God, we're not looking at it as being virtual. It's actual because we love the Lord, and our spirits make intercessions for us. And God, we pray that you will continue to keep our hearts in mind, God, and bring us back, God, to this appointed place and hour at the next appointed time. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.
Service for those who like to sing and testify to the glory and honor of God. Come on, Deacon Cleotis.